Good afternoon, everyone, and thank you very much for coming to the penultimate recital in this term's series. It's our fifth organ recital in February, which is unusual. And I worked out, if you would like to come to another series of five organ recitals in February at New College, you can come in 2052. So do come back next week to hear Matthew Yoritz, who is from Westminster Abbey. And it's a pleasure to welcome Edward Byrne to give today's recital from Magdalen College. And I'll let Edward introduce his program.
It's lovely to be here at New College today. I'll be playing a program of a variety of composers from the Baroque period to 20th century. I'll open the program with Bach's Prelude and Fugue in A minor. This was written during Bach's time in the Weimar court. The prelude starts in the Stilus Fantasticus style, and it's one of the composer's darkest openings, consisting mainly of broken chords and scales where the fugue is perpetuum mobile and carries rigorous energy all the way through to a virtuosic conclusion after a cadenza. Jehan, Alain was a French organist and composer in the early 20th century. Tragically, he was killed during the Second World War at the age of 29. And despite only composing for 10 years or so, he wrote some of the finest pieces of the 20th century French organ repertoire. I'll be playing the first and last of his trois pièces. The first is Variations sur un thème de Clément Jannequin, which was written for the Swiss organist Pierre Segon, a contemporary of Alain's at the Paris Conservatoire. It contains a theme and three variations. The first is the closest tonally to how Jannequin's theme would have originally been heard, and chromaticism seeps in as the piece goes on, thus exploring more 20th century tonality, which Alain's known for. As the title suggests, at the time of composition, it was thought to be based on a theme written by the French Renaissance composer Jannequin. However, the theme's now thought to have been written by an anonymous 16th century composer. The third piece of Alain's trois pièces is Litanies, which is arguably his most famous work. It contains influences from jazz and a repeated rhythm, which was influenced by train noises in the Parisian suburb of Saint-Germain-en-Laye, where Alain grew up. Alain wrote that if you get to the end without feeling exhausted, you have neither understood the piece nor played it as I would have wanted it. It's very much another example of continuous energy and movement in a piece. Dietrich Buxtehude was famously one of Bach's biggest inspirations. His Passacaglia is often talked about as an influence for Bach's C minor Passacaglia. It also influenced composers years down the line, such as Johannes Brahms, who refers to this as a beautiful piece which creates joy for others. This is obviously still the case, as it was featured only 8 years or so ago by the K-pop group BTS in their song Blood, Sweat and Tears. And to finish, I will play Moto, Ostinato, the third movement of Peter Eben's Musica Dominicalis. Like Alain, Eben was affected deeply by war. Despite his Catholic faith, he was imprisoned in Buchenwald concentration camp due to his father being Jewish. This dark nature of this piece mirrors Eben's troubled youth, with ominous melodies played on mutation stops below the continuous ostinato rhythm, which drives the whole piece before it ends abruptly on full organ.